and name I will, that tune.
I won't send roses, and it ends, and roses suit.
So I saw that show. I think I'm the only one left in New York who can say that.
Well, those of you who watch Theater Talk, I'm sure you know that song. It is from Jerry Herman's underappreciated show, Mac and Mabel, that really has one of the best scores of all time. And we are celebrating the music and lyrics of Jerry Herman tonight, are we not, Susan?
That's very good. And we are with our guest, Fred Barton, who is the leader of the 16-piece Fred Barton Orchestra, which is doing an evening celebrating Jerry Herman on Saturday, March 1st at the Michael Schimmel Center at Pace University.
Fred, I wanted to ask you, why an evening of Jerry Herman? Are we celebrating something of Jerry's, or has he always been a particular favorite of yours?
He's all of the above. He's always been a favorite of mine. You know, I saw Mac and Mabel when I was in high school, and it was put together by all of the same people who put together Hello, Dolly.
Gower Champion, Michael Stewart, David Merrick.
And Michael Stewart, who wrote the book to Hello, Dolly.
Fred has brought some terrific performers who are with him at his show coming up. Can I introduce the first one?
Oh, sure, absolutely.
You cannot, I'm telling you, you cannot do anything about Hello, Dolly without Leroy Reams. He directed Carol Channing in a number of revivals of the show. He is one of my favorite musical theater performers of all time. I saw him as a kid dancing on a quarter in 42nd Street.
Oh, I don't believe you. You were dancing along with him.
Everybody in the audience was dancing along with Leroy. That's how infectious this man is. So can we welcome to Theater Talk, Mr. Leroy Reams. Come on up. All right, now take it away, Leroy.
Yes.
And don't disappoint, please, will you?
So, Leroy, let's roll up our sleeves. We're going to give you a few songs from Hello, Dolly, with which Mr. Reams has a long association matched by none, except for maybe you know who. And this medley starts with some of the greatest chords ever written for the musical theater. Should we show them how it works?
You bet.
All right.
Barnaby, you and I are going to New York. Out there, there's a world outside of Yonkers. Way out there, beyond this hick town, Barnaby. There's a slick town, Barnaby. Out there, full of shine. Full of sparkle. Close your eyes and see it glisten, Barnaby. Listen, Barnaby. Put on your Sunday clothes, there's lots of world out there. Get out the brilliantine and dime cigars. We're gonna find adventure in the evening air. Girls in white and a perfume night, where the lights are bright as the stars. Put on your Sunday clothes, we're gonna ride through town in one of those new horse-drawn open cars. We'll see the shows at Delmonico's, and we'll close the town and the world, and we won't come home until we've kissed a girl. It only takes a moment for your eyes to meet, and then your heart knows in a moment you will never be alone again. I have but my arms felt sure and strong. It only takes a moment to be loved. Oh, long before the parade passes by, I'm gonna go and taste Saturday's high life before the parade passes by. I'm gonna get some life back into my life. I'm ready to move out in front. I've had enough of just passing by life with the rest of them, with the best of them. I'm gonna hold my head up high, for I've got a goal again, I've got a drive again. I'm gonna feel my heart coming alive again before the parade passes by. Look at that crowd up ahead. Listen and hear that brass harmony growing. Look at that crowd up ahead. Pardon me if my old spirit is showing. All of those lights over there seem to be telling me where I'm going. When the whistles blow and the cymbals crash and the sparklers light the sky, I'm gonna raise the roof, I'm gonna carry on. Give me an old trombone, give me an old baton before the parade passes by.
Woo! Yay!
Now, my concert series is called American Showstoppers, and this refers not only to the songs. The songs have to stop the show. That's the rule. But the performers, I like people who stop shows. And so I called Klea Blackhurst. And thank God she said, yes, she's going to sing Jerry Herman at my concert. And here she is.
Thank you.
Hi, Klea.
How are you?
I'm good.
That was very exciting.
Yeah.
I don't want to argue with Michael Riedel, but I saw Leroy dancing at 42nd Street as well. And he was dancing on a dime. Just for the record. Just for the record.
I almost said dime.
I know.
I can go back even further than that. I saw him in his first big New York job. I saw him in Oklahoma at Richard Rogers' personally supervised production of Oklahoma. Amazing. In 1969.
You're the real deal, Leroy.
Yeah.
Yes.
So I've covered all of Leroy's career.
Yes,
he's
we
pretty
love
well
it.
Covered all of yep. mine. So one of the things I like to do, I do the hits and the concerts, but I also like to do songs that are less well known. Because every songwriter writes songs that are less well known, that are every bit as good as the ones that happen to become known. And Jerry Herman wrote this song for Ethel Merman when he was trying to get her to appear in Hello, Dolly, and she turned the show down for various reasons. So this song went out of the show. But he put it back in.
Well, she was the final Dolly in the original Broadway run. I think the seventh choice after 13 times asking her. And she finally said, when he called this last time, she said, well, now that you got your previews out of the way, I'll come and I'll open your show.
Yeah, the show had been running 8 years or something like that.
So they thought it would be, she had heard rumors that there were these two songs written for her, and she went down, Jerry Herman played them, she loved them, and she wanted them both in the show, and David Merrick saw that as a great new selling point for the final 9 month run, which at the time allowed it to break the record as the longest running Broadway show in history.
But these songs have not been orchestrated since the original production and performed on a grand scale, as we're going to do on March 1st. But we thought we'd give you a little taste of what one of these songs was.
I've sliced my slice of life a little thin. Haven't I, Ephraim? I've been on the outside looking in. Haven't I, Ephraim? Well, from now on, Ephraim, all that, it's gonna change. The world is full of wonderful things, a bushel of wonderful things for me to believe in. So world, take me back. I wanna be part of the human race again and bid goodbye to all my trouble and tears. I've wasted so many odd years. It's time to get even. So world, take me back. I wanna let laughter light up
my face again. Oh, no more. Peeking through the keyhole, I intend to have my own key. No more. Sneaking past the parlor, from now on, that's me. Sitting on the settee, for today's a day to holler about for after just sitting life out since heaven knows when. My step has a spring and a drive, I'm suddenly young and alive. You wonderful world, take me back again. The world is full of April's and June's red roses and yellow balloons for me to hang on to. So world, take me back. I wanna be there in the good old days again. Whatever happened to those fabulous sights, those dancing the night away nights? Where have they gone? Oh world, take me back. I wanna be there when the gas lights blaze again. Oh, no more watching from the sidelines. I intend to star in the show. No more reaching for tomorrow. Today the world is ripe as a peach. It's gonna be mine till I reach 110. My step has a spring and a drive. I'm suddenly young and alive. You wonderful world, take me back again.
Thank you.
Come on back. So that song Jerry wrote for Ethel Merman, who, if I'm not mistaken, was going to do Dolly originally, right? Before
Well, he wanted her to do it.
Right.
And she had just come off of Gypsy and did the national tour of Gypsy. I think that's what made her think she just needed a break, because she normally did not tour with her shows.
Right.
Gypsy, she made the exception.
She also never had a flop. So in her mind, it's like she would do the show, it would be a hit, she'd be stuck with it. You know what I mean? It didn't occur to her, like, will it work?
But also, didn't you tell me, Leroy, that she also was tired of she didn't get the movie, The Gypsy, right?
That's right. And she said, you know, I put all the work into doing Broadway, and then I never get the film. And she just wanted to try something else. She just didn't want to make a commitment to a year or two of her life into something anymore.
Have Barbara Streisand do
that's
the movie.
Right. Hello, Dolly.
Yes.
Yeah, precisely. So, all right, it is
Fred Barton.
Fred Barton, American Showstoppers, an evening of Jerry Herman.
At
March
the,
1st.
You, the what's Michael the Schimmel Center at Pace University.
And don't forget Klea's wonderful...
Yeah, don't forget that.
Everything
make
the
sure
traffic
you take it
will
with
allow.
You, Michael.
I will.
It's a joy.
All right, can you play us out with a little something from...
Oh, sure. How about...
Thank you, Fred. Good night.